They shook hands on the stage of the Missouri Press Association Forum in Columbia Friday. Libertarian candidate Jonathan Dine of Kansas City was also there. McCaskill says this is a vote of contrast.
But not because we're at opposite ends, Todd and me. I'm in the middle. It's just he's so far on the fringe.
So your choice in this election is either more freedom as I have voted or more Washington, D.C. It's your choice.
Of course, Akin was asked about the legitimate rape comment.
And I don't believe that this election overall is about talk.
And then he moved on.
So it's not what he said that is the problem. It's what he believes that's the problem.
At several points during the debate, Medicare and the Obama health care law dominated.
Let's talk about somebody who voted to take $700 billion out of Medicare and then wants to crusade as the big hero of Medicare. I don't understand that.
This is the biggest whopper of this campaign season.
She explained there's $700 billion in savings in the health care law because of lower payments to providers, not to people on Medicare. She also charged Akin with voting for the same thing.
He knows that the Ryan budget took that same savings, but you know what they did with the savings? They gave another tax cut to Kim Kardashian.
Meaning the wealthy.
And I don't support, and neither did 71% of the Missouri public support, the bright idea of having the efficiency of the federal government and the compassion of the IRS running our health care.
When it was over, both believed they had scored.
Todd Akin is nowhere near the middle of the House of Representatives. He is perfectly comfortable on the fringe.
She's voted 98% of the time with Barack Obama. Now that doesn't strike me as moderate.
So that is how the first face-to-face meeting between Todd Akin and Claire McCaskill went, with the two trading shots on values, taxes, and entitlements. Michael Mahoney, KMBC 9 News, Columbia, Missouri.